Welcome, London Tom, London. Welcome, everybody. Welcome, my Tao. Hallelujah. Everybody, as you're coming in, we are typing in the comment section, watch my mouth. Yesterday, we started with God, watch my decisions. God was helping us to watch our decisions, but today we are asking the Lord to help us watch our mouth. Hallelujah. Good evening, good morning. Masiho, it's morning time now. It's 5 a.m. You're in the same country as me. God, watch my mouth, watch your mouth. You need to look at what your mouth is saying. Yes, we need to wash our mouths as well in Jesus' name. Amen and amen and amen. Father, help me to tame my tongue this morning. Tame my tongue this morning. Help me to watch my words. Help me to watch everything that I have been doing. Help me to be watchful and not be complaining. Hallelujah. Somebody help me declare in the comment section, God, watch my mouth. Hallelujah. God, watch my mouth. Tame my mouth. Tame my tongue. Do whatever is necessary to make sure that my mouth does not get me into trouble. Talk to me, somebody. Watch my mouth. Hallelujah. Watch my mouth, watch my mouth. I'm still waiting for that confirmation. Hallelujah. Let's just go back to something instrumental because I don't want any problems with... Oh, Jesus, help me, Lord. I don't want to play anything that would give us issues on these other platforms. Give me just a second. How are you guys doing? Okay. Have we shared the live? Hallelujah. Let's make sure we're sharing the live. It's one tap to the blessings. Yes, Bukenya. It's one tap, one share. One share is a kingdom gained in the gospel. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, I thank you for everybody that has tuned in this morning. Holy Spirit, I thank you, Lord, for the word that you're about to deliver, the word that will liberate, and the word that will take us to our new dimension in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you, Lord, for helping us to tame our tongues and to wash our mouths, Father God, and realign us with where your purpose is leading us in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you, Lord, that we are growing to a spiritual maturity level. Hallelujah. We are going places. We are going higher. We are changing levels in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Help me declare again in the comment section and say, watch your mouth. Hallelujah. Everybody who's listening to me, watch your mouth. Hallelujah. I'm going to start off with Proverbs chapter 18, verse 7. Hallelujah. I'm going to start from Proverbs chapter 18, verse 7. Hallelujah. I hope this is a scripture that all of us know very well. Amen, amen, amen. I'm doing so many technical things today, but God will help me in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. God, watch my mouth. Hallelujah. The devil is a liar. Watch my mouth. Proverbs 18 verse 7 says, a fool's mouth is his ruin. Hallelujah. So we should be careful about what we say with our mouth because it can ruin us. And it says his lips are the snare of his soul. His lips are the snare of his soul. And as you track with me to Psalms 141 verse 3, the book of Psalms 141 verse 3 says, set a guard, O Lord, over my mouth. Keep watch over the door of my lips to keep me from speaking thoughtlessly. So the scripture teaches us this morning that at times we can say things and speak things thoughtlessly without thinking through what we are saying. Amen. So we should be watchful in terms of what comes out of our mouth. And as I track also to Matthew 12:36, this is my last scripture that I just wanted to anchor the whole message and the whole prayer direction. It says, "But I tell you, on the day of judgment, people will have to give an account for every careless word that they speak." Hallelujah. So these are scriptural directions that are written in the Word of God, indicating that there are things we need to be accountable for, and our mouth is probably the most dangerous thing. So we are looking at a very critical topic, and I find myself in a dilemma a little bit this morning, because I found myself waking up having come through from a dream that was so intense that I wanted to actually unpack it. And the Lord, as I was getting prepared, He says, "No, you're not gonna share it. It's not time. I'm not releasing you to it." So I now learned this principle practically this morning, that there are things that are meant for a specific season. There are things that you release in a specific time season. I'm trusting God that tonight at our midnight prayer, He's going to help me release this, because in that lies a lot of deliverance. Because what I was seeing and where God was taking me to, He was showing me things, specific people, specific names, specific things that were done in terms of the evil aspect of things like witchcraft and all these things. And I was like, "God, do you not want me to warn them about it?" And it was like, "No, it's not time yet. You need to lay the foundation so that you know and you train them how to articulate it when the time comes." Because, you know, sometimes when you know about something that has been done or something that has been said about you, you are tempted to go and say. So no wonder I was meditating on the word of taming the mouth and looking at the mouth. God bless you, Anna. Thank you so much. God bless everyone who's gifting. God bless those who are joining in on the subscriptions as well. God bless you. It makes a huge difference. Amen. So today we are looking at a very critical topic. We've got our pre-warnings, and I know I would have loved to bring a word that probably would excite you, but today God has really sent me with hello Habib, that is going to be more of a word of rebuke and a word of correction rather, that we should really look closely at. And it gives us the warnings in the scriptures to say we must be very careful, because our mouth can ruin us and our lips can be the snare of our souls. We must set guard. That means we must put protective actions or people who are guarding our mouths, and we need to guard our mouth. So today we're going to be praying, God, keep watch over the door of my lips, so that I don't say things that are going to sabotage me, so that I don't say things that are going to ruin me, so I don't say things prematurely. And some of these things that God is saying is that some of us have got good news, and He's actually putting a restriction on when you're actually going to release your good news. The same way, there are certain dreams that you cannot tell people yet, and I know that it is, you are excited because you have seen the light and you have seen the answer that God is giving you. God bless you, Jenica. So, but there's a time that is that word will be released. There's a time that dream will be visible by itself even. So God is sending me with a warning this morning to say, watch what you say. Not only can it destroy you, but you can say good things too prematurely, too early. And the Lord began to deal with me with people that we are revealing certain things to, because we are saying certain things to certain people thinking that they're going to celebrate with us. Somebody type in the comment section, somebody who doesn't know what we are talking about. We are saying we are watching our mouth. Watch your mouth. We are talking to ourselves this morning to say, Fortune, watch your mouth. Everybody on Mara Official, please make sure you are sharing the live broadcast and you are ticking on the screen there. Click on the screen. Make sure you send those likes. Let's get more people who are going to be liberated, who are going to be knowing how to watch their mouth. mouth. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. I tell you, on the day of judgment, people will have to give an account for every word, every careless word, every useless word. Sometimes we say certain things that are useless. Let me help this person. Hallelujah. Koraba shande kele bahasata. Roko sheke tekiya bahasato konya masa. Likra soto konde be sheke tekida bahasa. Liko soto to konya baha. Rakasando do 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 boshia. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. There are things that we say carelessly with our mouth. There are words that we use uselessly. And I think this is something which is a correction even more for us as women, because sometimes as women, we've got more words than anything. My daughter says, I speak like an auctioneer. I don't know if you guys agree. And I laughed the other day because every time I'm in prayer or anytime I'm on any stage, even in a boardroom, the way I speak fast, hallelujah. And she says, Mom, do you know you sound like an auctioneer? I think you were an auctioneer before in so speaking for some of us, we've got more words, and sometimes our words rush before, you know, what where my mind is. I'm already 10 minutes ahead of what I'm planning to say. Hallelujah. Thank you that you still love me, even though they are making jokes of me in the house that I sound like an auctioneer. But back to the serious matters. As I said, today we are looking at a critical topic which has succeeded in stealing so much from people, the people of God. Your mouth can steal so much from you. We pray a lot of prayers, and sometimes we see that the prayers don't get answered, and we need to ask ourselves the question, why are those questions not being answered? Hallelujah. The devil is stealing away so much from us, and he's stealing our success, because we are more speakers than listeners. We don't listen very carefully. We talk while people are still talking. Talk to me, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The devil does not have much power as we think, but it is us that actually empower him with what we say with our mouth. We say things prematurely before God has released us to say certain things. And sometimes we say things we shouldn't say. Hallelujah. And those things have broken our families. Those things have broken our relationship with our siblings. And those things have broken our relationships in the workplace. Those things have sabotaged our promotions. So somebody, please tell your neighbor, watch your mouth. Talk to me, somebody. There is a need for us to study how the mouth works and how the mouth operates. You want the scriptural references again, my moderators? Talk to me, somebody. Proverbs 18:7, Psalms 141:3, Matthew 12:36. I hope you got it. I hope you got it. Matthew 12:36, Psalms 141:3, and Proverbs 18:7. I'm moving now. So my moderators, keep up and catch up with those pinning of those scriptures. Hallelujah. So we are the ones who actually empower the devil to sabotage us. We are the ones that actually God can be everywhere. God knows all things, but the devil does not know all things. It is us who empower people. We've got friends that we talk too much to. We say too many things to too many people too prematurely. And our friends are the ones who are the little birdies that are carrying around these messages and these things that are going to happen. And sometimes we get people who are calling us and they say, what's happening in your life? They are not really interested in knowing what is happening in your life. Am I talking to somebody this morning? I hope this is resonating with somebody. That person actually just wants you to unfold and unravel whatever it is, and you are the one who's going to empower him with what is going on. And that's my God, help me not to get to tonight yet. But watch your mouth. Can somebody say it again and say, watch your mouth? Hallelujah. So we are the ones, we need to be careful about what we are saying with our mouth. So today, I feel like we are going into a master class where we're going to learn how to manage our mouth. Hallelujah. We are in a master class and we are going to manage our mouths. Hallelujah. We are going to manage what is coming out of our mouth. Turn to your neighbor and tag your neighbor and tell them, manage your mouth. This is a management course to manage your mouth. Talk to me, somebody. We need to make sure that our prayers get answered, that we are not the cause that our prayers are not being answered. Talk to me, hallelujah. What the devil does is he studies our weaknesses and he positions us in a place, hallelujah, where we break the law of God. Hallelujah. He wants us to say certain things, and I'm going to explain this when I start talking about the temple of God a bit earlier. My God, you will not succeed. Sorry. sorry. Sometimes when I'm going through this, there's things that I'm seeing that I need to rebuke. Some attacks that come. Hallelujah. Rakoshonda, manage your mouth. Manage your mouth. Hallelujah. We'll deal with this. Kaliyabasoto. Ikalamasonda. So sometimes it's automatic. We find ourselves getting into trouble. The devil manipulates people using small things to steal from them. He uses small things. He uses your mouth to steal the breakthrough that God intends for you. He uses your mouth to steal the release of your blessings. Talk to me. He manipulates you to actually sinning against your own body, which is the temple of God. I will explain it when I give another illustration a bit earlier. So if there is ever a university that you needed to come into this morning, that is the university that you will come out with a degree that qualifies you, that you've got a degree in management of your mouth, a qualification in management of your mouth. You must be able to master that one. And once you master that one, you are the best. Let me tell you something else that resonated with me, and God spoke to me about this yesterday, is that in your silence, there is power. Your silence carries so much power. That, you know, people must never know or what you're always thinking. And when God uses you, especially if you are a man or a woman of God, you need to exercise silence even more. The more of the word is what you need. You need to learn the word more than anything. Without the word, the devil will not respect you. When you carry the word of God inside of you, that is what you're going to use. That is the weapon you're going to use against the devil. That is the word that you're going to use against principalities. That is the justification that you are going to use against any principality that tries to attack you or bring you down. Hallelujah. Your prayer life, there are two critical things that you should never mess around with: the word level and your prayer life. You cannot mess around with these two things. And if you keep silent, he comes at you and he thinks he's going to get you. He thinks you don't know better. And that's when you hit. A lot of people that talk too much are the ones who are actually failing you. You find that they are talking and they are screaming, but they've got no word content. And when they don't have, when you are to open your mouth, make sure you are opening your mouth for a proper content of the word of God. Am I communicating to somebody? Your word and your prayer life needs to be so much on point. And keep your mouth quiet. Be silent. When it's time for you to speak, you will speak. The devil does not respect a man or a woman who does not have word. And if you don't have the word of God, if you don't know the word of God, there is nothing of value you are going to say. So you might as well keep quiet, because whatever it is that is going to come out of your mouth will likely be careless or will likely be useless. So whatever it is, that is why some people, there is a difference. There is somebody who can call on the name of Jesus when they are facing an attack, and there is another person next door who's facing an attack, and they say, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke you. The other one does not have an effect. The other one has an effect. Why does the other one come with an effect? Because the other one has a manifestation anointing with it. It comes with the heaviness that says, yes, I am now, I've got a word base that I'm carrying. That is why I'm listening to this one. You are saying the name of Jesus. I know Jesus. I know Paul. I know this other one who's saying, I rebuke in the name of Jesus, but you don't have the foundation for it. Come on, somebody, let me come back and talk to you and school you in the university of your mouth. Let your mouth be silent. Learn to be silent. It's not everything you need to comment on. It's not everything you need to talk about. Don't be the one who's always feeling you have to have an opinion about everything. Sometimes it's good to walk away, and people are wondering, what are you thinking about? What is going on in your mind? What is going to be your next move? Keep quiet, be silent, walk away. This is the best thing some of you can do for yourselves, even in your marriages. Talk to me, somebody. So the devil sets traps for us. He wants us to use our mouth carelessly. And, you know, he wants us to empower him to use information against us, because now he gets to know our weak points. Sometimes the weaknesses that we identify in ourselves, we need to be very careful that who we tell it to. Because sometimes we tell it to people who are thinking that they are friends, they're gonna sympathize with us, they're gonna maybe come up with a solution, but actually they're gonna use it against you one day. They know exactly what is your weakness. And maybe your friend was actually a sweet person, and they actually were feeling genuine pity for you, and they wanted a solution, but they go and run their mouth to the wrong person. So today we are getting that degree in management of the mouth. Talk to me, somebody. You must plug your life into the ministry of mouth management this morning. Somebody say, God, manage my mouth. Today I'm getting that degree. Watch my mouth. I'm gonna watch my mouth. Hallelujah. You do not want to talk yourself out of your miracle, because many people have spoken carelessly and have spoken themselves out of their miracles. Talk to me, somebody. You don't want to talk yourself out of your breakthrough through your mouth. So somebody please declare with me in the comment section and says, watch your mouth. I'm not gonna talk myself out of my miracle. I'm not gonna talk myself out of my breakthrough. I'm not gonna hand over my breakthrough to the enemy just like that and talk myself silly. Talk to me, somebody. Any small thing that I say might become a big thing. Hallelujah. So I'm gonna be careful. I'm gonna be watchful. So you saw that the first scripture that I shared, hallelujah, it means that the mouth has mysterious and dangerous capacity to destroy things in your life. There are things that can be destroyed. The capacity of your mouth is so big, they can destroy certain things in your life. Come on, somebody. Manage my mouth. God, please help me manage my mouth this morning. Hallelujah. Your mouth can kill you. It's that simple. The first scripture on Proverbs that I gave you, it simply is a simple instruction. You don't need a prophetic analysis on it. It says your mouth can kill you. Watch your mouth. If you are coming in late and you are seeing people typing in the comment section, join them in and declare with me and say, watch your mouth. You're not gonna die because of your mouth. Talk to me, somebody. It also means that the mouth can be a trap for us. A mouth can be a snare. Then I'm on now the second scripture that I gave you that teaches you that you can be snared by the words of your lips. Hallelujah. The enemy can use the lips of your mouth to snare you. Hallelujah. He can use it to steal. He can use you to cage you. He can use it to bastardize you. He wants you to be a bastard. He wants to steal from you. He wants to cage your destiny, and that you can give him release to your mouth. Somebody say, watch your mouth. Watch your mouth. We're gonna watch our mouth this morning. Watch your mouth. Hallelujah. The enemy wants to use your mouth to cage you, and he's not gonna succeed this morning. I'm gonna watch my mouth. I'm gonna manage my mouth. I'm gonna make sure that I get my degree in my mouth management in Jesus' mighty name. I'm not gonna allow my mouth to make my breakthroughs to be stolen in Jesus' mighty name. Psalms 141 verse 3. The psalmist prayed that prayer, and it says it is a prayer that, you know, that we should also, all of us should want to pray that prayer. Come on, somebody. There are prayers and there are prayers, but there are prayers that are very, very serious. Hallelujah. You can pray as many prayer points as you want, but you need to shout it out loud and clear and say, set a watch over my mouth, O Lord. God, my prayer this morning to you is this. Set a watch over my mouth. Set a watch over my mouth, O Lord. That is the biggest prayer point that we're going to pray today. Keep the door of my lips, O God. Set a watch over my mouth and keep the door of my lips. Let God keep the door. Give God the keys. Give God the spare keys if you need to. And say, God, only you open my mouth when you need to. When it's time, you can put the key there. But you keep the door of my lips. Hallelujah. So we begin to understand that the psalmist understood that the mouth can destroy you totally. He says his mouth needed a watching over. He needed a gatekeeper to the door of his lips. Hallelujah. Let me ask this question, and this question is for everybody, not for some people. If everyone that you know or that knows you heard about everything that you have said, every word that has come out of your mouth, anything that you have said about them behind their back, how do you think they would feel? Are you confident that at this point, at this moment, anybody who can know everything that you have said about them, are you sure that you would still have friends by the end of this broadcast? If right now your book would be open, if right now everybody would just get the message and say, hey, do you know that Stephanie said this? Do you know that Steve said this? Do you know that Megan said this about you? If everybody got to know, are you proud of it? If you're not proud of it, you're going to have to realign yourself and say, no, I think I failed that module. I need to come back, Pastor Fortune, into the University of Mouth Management. I'm going to manage my mouth now. I need to take that course again. Come on, somebody. If everybody in your office, now I'm waiting for the answers, guys. You're not responding to me. Talk to me. If everybody in your office knew everything that you have said about them, would they still respect you and look at you the same way? Would they still be looking at you and talking to you today? Thank you for those who are already repenting. God bless those who are gifting. Those, there are people who are saying, you see, I'm prisoner says, no, if they knew what I've said about them, they wouldn't respect me. They wouldn't be talking to me. You wouldn't be having friends. So this goes to prove that we needed this word. We needed to break through this word. We wouldn't be having jobs, some of us, if people knew the things we said. If your boss knew the things you say half the time, not even a quarter or maybe even a third. Come on. Thank you so much. You guys are honest and fortunate online. In the church where you go to, where you fellowship, would the pastor even be looking? Would the pastor even be wanting to take your call if they knew what you said about them? Would the other congregants, the other members of your church know? Some of you, when people are even going up to the stage and they're giving their testimonies, and you probably have said statements like, oh, they think they're all that and a bag of chips. They think they're better than everybody. And what was the necessity? Let me ask, what was the necessity of saying such a statement? Was it necessary? No. Did you have to comment? No. Did the words add any value? No. Come on, somebody. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for everybody who's repenting. This is how you get out of the masterclass. Everybody who's going to repent and be truthful, you are going to graduate in this masterclass. Talk to me. My God. Stephanie says, God, close my mouth. I repeat, God, close my mouth. Because some of us, we are not natural gossipers, but something about gossip just pulls out to this direction. Exactly, they will not respect. I'm seeing the repentance. Facebook, are you repenting? God bless you. Thank you so much for the gift. Let's repent, guys, because the things that have come out of our mouth, they don't add value. You didn't have to comment, you know. And some of us have got a problem with sarcasm. Somebody is passing in the street and you want to comment about their dressing. Is it necessary? Is it building the person? Is it going to shatter the person? Must you comment in everything? Who cares about what you need to do? Lord, take charge of my mouth. God bless those who are joining the teams as well. God bless you. Would you still be welcome in that church where you are gathering? What are you telling your children about the church? And you come back from a meeting, you've complained about your boss. Now your children are starting to formulate this idea and mindset that, hey, at work there's evil people. At church there's evil people. Everybody's evil except my parents. We are the ones who are planting all this nonsense. And some of us are even wondering why our children don't want to go to church anymore. Because all they hear is about every complaint, about how this church mother did this, how did they did this, they didn't listen to my opinions. And they're looking at this is a very big mess. Thank you, Jesus. I think I'm loving these. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the repentance for those who are realizing the things that they have said that have been not building in their marriages. Sometimes there are things that we don't need to comment about. We don't need to comment about certain things in our marriages. Is it necessary to say that thing at that time? My God, may the Lord forgive us. Father, set a watch over my mouth. Set a watch over my mouth. Hallelujah. You understand that your body is the temple of God. And there are certain things that you wouldn't do in a temple of God. So even if you are in a church and you are respecting it and you're saying, I'm going to the temple of God and I'm going to be praying there. There are certain things that you shouldn't be saying. Some people don't have the respect for even going to church. And they go to church. Hallelujah. They go to church and they start chatting. You are chatting during praise and worship. You are chatting, somebody's leading prayer in the front. You don't respect the space. You don't respect the holy ground. So if you cannot respect your church, wherever you're holding fellowship, and you can't respect your job, you can't respect yourself. That says a lot about yourself, because it talks to also your own personal being. Because your body is the temple of the Lord. So anytime you engage yourself in gossip, anytime you engage yourself in things that are off key, and you are saying things, the same way that you wouldn't allow certain things to be consumed in your body, because you understand the respect and the honor you need to give to your body because it's the temple of God. But other people, they just run their mouth anyhow. You come into church, you make noise. You come into church, you behave like, you know, you don't follow instruction. You don't give the temple a respect. Your body is not going to be respected as well. Hallelujah. You are around people, you know, there's a scripture, and I'll get the reference for it. The scripture that talks about in Psalm 1, it says, do not be found in the counsel of unbelievers, or do not take counsel from people who are unbelievers, or people who have wicked counsel. But there's another one specifically that talks about not being found in the company of brawlers, in the company of the wicked people, in the company of people that talk badly against your God, in the company of people that talk badly about your church and all these things. Sometimes we find ourselves around people that are attacking the church. They are gossiping. Hallelujah. We shouldn't be found ourselves in such discussions. We shouldn't be even entertaining. You're saying, but Pastor, I didn't even comment. I didn't say anything. You didn't even defend the body of Christ either. Yesterday, I gave you an example of how I probably would have been married much earlier in my life, but because I opened up my mouth about how good my relationship was going to a friend, and that friend sabotaged me big time and told lies about the potential suitor. And years later, more than 10 years later, he says, remember that thing, I need to come and repent. I actually lied because I was jealous. So that is a warning. And God has been showing me so many warnings. I'm going to share them tonight. Not about me necessarily. Some of you, as the Lord permits me, I will tell you who is the issue that has been giving you problems. Hallelujah. By the will of God. Thank you, Jesus. Those people that are around you, when they are attacking you, they are attacking the people you love, they are attacking the church. It's like, it's gossip anonymous. It's not even gossip anonymous. You are like the local BBC or the local CNN news. You are the news broadcaster of everything that is evil. You are the one who's just taking one story after the next. Like, what are you benefiting from going around and telling people that, oh, you know what, Bukenya is not doing very well? Meanwhile, you are busy announcing to exactly that person who hates Bukenya and saying, I'm glad my charm is working. My evil charm is working. I see that testimony. Some people, you need to keep your home as a private space. Don't allow people who just come into your house because they say they want to come and see you. What do they want to come and see? Some people come into your homes not only to just gossip and to just... they want to see how bad you're doing. My God. Somebody say, watch my mouth. There is no such thing as small gossip and big gossip. Any gossip is gossip and sin is sin. It also carries the same weight. If you are finding yourself comfortable, if, for example, what you are saying about other people, other your church members, people who you are fellowshipping with, behind their back, you're comfortable about it, check yourself. That thing is going to destroy you. That thing is going to hold back your answered prayers. You are losing so many things by the cheap tricks of the enemy. The enemy keeps on setting you up for trouble. Father, I pray for every single person who's at the sound of my voice today. Let their understanding be open in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, to understand the impact of their mouth, to understand the impact of their lips. Father God, help us to manage our mouth in Jesus' mighty name. Why do I need to manage my mouth? Why are you so passionate about this, Pastor Fortune, this morning? Your mouth will determine your life's direction. Your mouth will determine the direction of your life. In fact, the truth is that your life today is as a result of what you were saying yesterday, what you said last year, what you said last month. So if you keep on saying the things that you are saying and you are not liking how your life is currently looking, you need to blame your mouth. And if you continue, if you choose to continue saying the things you were saying yesterday and before, then you can then be ready that you're going to continue having the same type of lifestyle that you're having. Some people who are on this broadcast, the reason why you lost your job, it was because of your mouth. It's your mouth. That's the honest truth. And you thought nobody actually told you. Some people are being recorded. These days, evil is so much that people will even record you. And you don't know. And you go and justify and say, me? I'm a Christian. I could have never said that. I'm a Christian. I'm born again. And meanwhile, somebody is sitting with a recording of the nonsense that you said. That's the truth. Some people lost their jobs because they said too much during a meeting. You decided to make yourself shop steward. There is a way you can articulate if your rights are being infringed, if your rights are being not respected in a workplace. God can give you the words to actually address. Amen, somebody. You can address people in authority properly. That was one of the things I learned in ministry. And that's why sometimes I feel it's not good to be a renegade and to say, God called me and I'm just sending myself. Don't send yourself. There's a calling and there's a sent. There's a calling and there's a sent. It's biblical. You may have the calling of God in your life. You may have the talents and the gifts of God. There's a point you are called and there was a point where you are sent. And hopefully between the calling and the sent, there's some training that happens. Because if other people, if some of us didn't have the training, we would have just been rebels. We've just been rebels. That's why that's how you can differentiate people who did not have a mentor that spoke to them and said, you don't say certain things like this. My God. Why should I manage my mouth, Pastor Fortune? The tongue is one of the smallest muscles in your body. But it has the power to change your life for the positive or for the negative. Your tongue has the power to determine the course of your life. It can destroy people around you because you said too much too soon and you feel that you are all that and you think that you have to speak your mind in everything. No, we don't want to speak your mind. We don't want to hear your mind. We want to hear the mind of God. And if you don't know what is the mind of God concerning that particular situation, walk away and time out until you are calm before you say anything. Don't be hyped up by people who are fighting. We're gonna fight management today. We're gonna tell them exactly, do you even have a strategy? Do you know how to address people? Do you know how that my mentor told me, you may disagree with what I'm deciding. And if I'm in a church meeting and you are a leader, and you don't agree that we should undertake a particular project or we shouldn't do it in a particular way, you can address me in that meeting. And you're not going to stand up and say, Pastor, I think you are wrong. We shouldn't do that. Do you know that by those words, you have disrespected, you have dishonored. And that person is already closed up. They're not going to listen to you. And I believe the same principle happens even in our workplaces. You can't stand up and tell the CEO, CEO, I think you are... This person was paid a large salary. They are paid more than quadruple what you are earning. They were put in leadership for a reason. Can I help some people today? There is a reason why you did not submit your application for that position that said CEO. It's not because you didn't have the qualifications only, but the more you go higher up in the ladder of the corporate environment, you get to a point where it's not only about the qualifications. They look at your character. They look at your personality. They take you for psychometric tests because they want to make sure that they're not going to hire a person who is going to be a lunatic. I'm not talking about positions where people are getting there by corruption and you know that this person does not have any leadership qualities. But the reason why there is a protocol and a leadership structure and an organogram in an organization that says this one does this, this one does this,
There are people who scientifically sat down and drew up examinations and tests that are determining who's able to lead this team, who's able to have management skills. They're not gonna put people in charge who are losing their mind, who are just snapping all the time. Every time when people are trying to highlight to you that there's a better way of doing something, you are snapping and you are saying that they are questioning your authority. No. Because a true leader will listen to your suggestion. And they will even tell you, let's take it offline. Let's discuss that offline. And so that we can understand. Am I communicating with somebody? Let's take this offline so that we can you take me further and into the strategy that you want to bring along. Maybe there's a room for modification. But the minute you tell somebody, I think you're wrong. You don't know what you're talking about. This thing is not going to work. I'm not going to listen to you. If I'm your boss, I'm not going to listen to you. I'm going to think that you've got the audacity to disrespect me in front of all the other employees. And you're telling me I'm wrong. So you saying that the thing I've been meditating on for the past week and the decision that I have come to after consulting with other people who are on the executive team, and we have come to a consensus that this is what we are bringing to the organization, you're going to have to and just stand up and tell me that we are talking nonsense. And then you wonder why you lost your job. My God, let me get out. I'm saying this so that you repent and you don't do the same mistake on the next job that God is going to give you. God is going to... This is the... Whenever you come in the presence of God, this is ministry, guys. This is ministry. This is what God has called us to do, to also give a word of correction. That's why I don't shake. I don't... Those people who are waiting for me to say you're going to receive your kind of... That has its own season and its own time when the Holy Spirit directs me that way. But I hope that you are taking these corrections and you are looking at... Because some of you, it's not witchcraft that is your problem. It's your mouth. It's the mouth. Luto, God bless you. Are you being motivated? Hallelujah. I'm equipping you and I'm giving you the skills to know that, you know what? And maybe the approach that your boss was going to take was wrong. But because of your approach, I was taught in church, ask a clarity-seeking question. Pastor, is there a way that maybe we could explore? Have you perhaps maybe explored doing X, Y, Z as opposed to B, C, D? Then I've already planted a thought in this person's mind to say, let's explore this. Okay, Fortune, thank you. We're going to explore that. Let's give it some time. Or you might be given task and say, oh, Rabakadia Masunda, you will not ruin it, my darling. Sid, you are going to repent. If you have seen, if through this discussion that we are having now, this is meant to liberate you, this is meant to deliver you so that you do things in a correct way. Take the teaching. Take what is good. You might not like my nose. You might not like anything else. But trust me, the teaching is coming from not only a good motivated place and a good heart, but it's coming from experience as well. Because I have seen people who ran their mouth and they just lost it. And remember, you are dealing with human beings. Those human beings, when there's time for retrenchment, and they say, you know what? This one comes to work. God bless you guys. But their mouth... I can't trust their mouth. I can't send them into a negotiation, into a work with a client, because I don't know what they're going to say with their mouth. They talk so much. Guys, some of the things are irrelevant. Don't talk about your children so much at work, about what you're going through at work. You are the one who exposes your weaknesses at work. Hallelujah. There was an organization I worked on, and they asked me, why don't you bring pictures of your children at work? Why don't we see on your desk? What do you want to see about my children on my desk? There's a time, if I'm in a workplace environment that is warm like that, but I understand how to read a situation. Because you must be wise as serpents. There are environments that people will evaluate. They want to see whether or not are you taking your job seriously. To another boss, I'm not saying it's wrong to bring your pictures of your children and put them on your desk, but you might be serving a boss who thinks that that is a weakness. By the time they look at that, they are thinking, this one is always going to be asking me for time off to go pick up the kids. Are you getting me? Take Take it if it works for you, if you don't take it, but it's okay. But let's be careful. The tongue, let me make sure that I finish on time. Hopefully this time, this is my first closing. It can destroy those around you because we talk badly. People will laugh. We say things that we shouldn't say. And that's why there's a danger in banking things in us. If something is troubling you, if something has been a thorn in your flesh, please calm down, talk to the person, address it and move on. Don't bank things into a point that when they now do something silly, the argument was supposed to be about who didn't do the dishes. And now you have taken out the fact that they didn't, they paid the bond late, they paid the mortgage late, they don't help around the house, they are useless and everything. You come out with every word, every vocabulary that you can think of that wants to scatter the person and break the person down. Watch your mouth. Somebody say it in the comment section. Watch your mouth. Address issues when they need to be addressed. Don't make them pile up. People who are in groups, in cabals. They are always in cabals. They are busy hyping each other up. You know, and that manager Fortune, she said this, and that one said, yeah, she also said this on. You are letting it pile up. You are letting it pile up. There's gonna be a day, and you were supposed to address very one simple thing with manager Fortune, but there you went. My God. If you don't watch your mouth, the other thing that you need to be careful about, that it will question your credibility. Because you're always saying things, and sometimes you don't have proof of it. You don't have the evidence of it. You are just going on a whim. You are just going and saying whatever you want, whenever you want, however you want to say it. It questions your credibility because you didn't produce evidence. God bless you, Jenica. You didn't produce evidence, and this time you think we must believe you. And at that time, shame, you are coming with a real thing, and it's true. You are wanting to warn them, you want to warn the other person, but because there's no credibility, don't say things unless you can prove them. Let me go here and just leave it very quickly. It's good that you want to warn your friend about a cheating spouse, a cheating boyfriend, and all these things. But be calculative how you're gonna say it, because some people will kick you and push you out. They don't wanna hear it. They're not ready for it unless you have the evidence for it. Come on, talk to me. If you don't watch your mouth, it can take you to hell. Because every negative word you could not confirm, you keep on repeating it, but it's a negative word. You keep on repeating it again. It's negative and negative. You keep on repeating negative words against yourself, negative words against your children. Yes, like, you know, I don't know whose these children are. They're not like me. I don't know where they took their brain. Oh my God. Oh, they are so dumb. Keep on repeating that negative word. It will come into fruition. It's going to take root. Come on, somebody. Some people have got the audacity to say things that they were not even at the place, but the way the person is telling the story, it's like you were there physically and you were not there. It's hearsay. That thing did not happen in your presence, but you are busy broadcasting it. Who created you to be CNN and BBC to be announcing things that have got nothing to do with you? You're announcing it as if you were there. Some people, you tell them as something that it will be the one who's broadcasting and say, did you know? Did you hear about this? I'm the one that told you that story. Why are you telling it to me again? That should be a warning sign already. Hallelujah. It's those kind of things that will land you in hellfire, and things are not going right in your life. Tom, talk to me, somebody. Somebody say, watch your mouth. When you get into the house of God, from now on, sit down. Sit down and keep quiet and thank God for bringing you to the service and learn and say, I'm here to learn. Stop talking. Whether your pastor has got degrees like you, degrees more than, you know, he might not even have a degree. He might not have a matric. But do you know that God can use that person to change your life? And you think because of your PhD, you are entitled to just run your mouth. Watch your mouth. Watch your mouth. Some things are not scientific. Some things are not by your degrees. Some things are spiritual. And some things are so basic, and they are basic, based on the logos of God. These things that I'm saying, guys, I'm not saying them from the head of Fortune. Go through the book of Proverbs. check yourself and see what the word teaches you. The same as when I talk about nutrition and I say some of the diseases and the illnesses that we are finding ourselves in, it's because we did not eat the right nutrition. Is it in somebody? Is there a diet book that somebody wrote? Yes, it's in the Bible. They tell us exactly what to eat and what to avoid eating. But no, because we think we are cute. I'm not talking about those people that have got hereditary disease of genetic issues about diabetes and all these things. But some of this high blood pressure nonsense can be eradicated. It doesn't need to be a prayer point. It needs to be a nutrition point, a nutrition addressing point. You can't drink like a camel drinking water and you expect your liver to remain intact. Yes, we can pray for the reversal. We pray for the mercy of God. We pray for the repairing. But you need to understand that some people are actually paying the price of the mistakes that they did. But I'm not going there because I just want to talk about the mouth today. So let's not form the habit of going to the house of God and begin to chat recklessly and begin to be noisy and begin to be wanting to be broadcasters of people's business and stop broadcasting your own business, for crying out loud. Keep the things to yourself. Your boyfriend is good to you, great stuff. Keep it to yourself. You know, when you get to broadcast good news without even giving the details, when your enemies are monitoring you, when your enemies are looking at you and they want to know what's going on in your life and they're asking you, and you know that the person is asking from an evil standpoint and say, what is happening in your life, Aletta? You say, wow, God is good. Stop posting nonsense on your statuses, because even our mouths speak through our statuses on social media. You want to go complain, you want to go hang your dirty linen on the statuses. You think somebody's going to catch feelings for you and say, oh, shame, sorry, your husband is really putting you through a lot. You know, men are trash, blah, 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 blah. No, shut up your mouth. On your status, go through a garage and go take a picture next to a beautiful car and they say, God is wonderful. Watch how many calls and how many SMSs you will get after saying that. Am I communicating to somebody? Somebody say, watch your mouth. Watch your mouth. You don't have to lie and you don't have to say, I bought the car. If you didn't buy the car, if you bought the car, you just say, wow. Or somebody, you just say, type on the comment section, God is wonderful. Meanwhile, they know that they are busy doing witchcraft against you. They don't understand, what are you confessing about this wonderfulness and the wowness all about? If you didn't buy the car, it's okay. Taking pictures is free. They allow you to take a picture. You take a picture. You didn't say it's your house. You didn't say it's your car. You just say, wow, thank you, Jesus. That will reveal to you who is after your things. Who is the broadcasters that you should be watchful about? Hallelujah. When you go into the house of God, it's not a mountain of chatting and everything else. You're there to get your goods. You're there to worship and fellowship with your God. You are there to get your miracles. Sit down, talk to your God. God has brought you there. The moment you want, you need to maximize the time you're there. You're on this broadcast. Maximize the time you're on this broadcast. Say the right things. Comment the right things. We are in agreement with you. Every single thing we are reading, we are agreeing with you. The Spirit of the Lord is moving in this place. Take advantage of being here. That's why we don't care. I don't give attention to even trollers anymore. You have to have thick skin to even be on TikTok, because trollers, they just feel the need to just come in and say stupid things. Don't give them the light of day. Don't be shaken by them. If they could run their own lives, let them go and run their own lives and say whatever they want to say. Exactly, Mam Sophie. Some of you, you post your victories, and then suddenly there's an accident. So keep quiet. Somebody say, watch my mouth, watch your mouth, watch your mouth. Hallelujah. Your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. The temple of God shall be respected. You must give maximum respect in the temple of God. You must give maximum respect to your temple, your own body. Come on, somebody. When you come into his house, sit down. Take your Bible. Don't mind other people's business. Whether the person is wearing a flowery dress. There are people, you know, one day I didn't understand when somebody was actually making a funny comment and was trying to be mean to me. And they said, my God, you look so flowery. You know, you look so, I like your dress. It looks so Christmassy. And I thought they liked the colors that I was wearing. But it was actually somebody trying to mock me. But because I wasn't paying attention to their being mean, and I just continued in my life. And a friend pointed out, he says, that person was actually mocking you and laughing at you. Hallelujah, somebody. Anybody who wants to chat with you and gossip with you, let them, I don't know, I don't even listen to them. Hallelujah. So your mouth determines where you're going. Your words can destroy you. Make sure that your words don't destroy where you're going. Your words can destroy what you already have. Some of you, your issues in your marriage need to be watched. Am I communicating? I hope this is helping somebody. Please feel, if you feel that there's somebody who can benefit, share with them, tag them or whatever. It can destroy what you already have. Because some people, they would not have known if you didn't post certain things on social media. Some people who are struggling back home in the villages where there is that old man who has said, you will never amount to anything. And suddenly somebody says, daddy, look at that child from that third street. They are graduating and they've done this. This is their house in the United Kingdom. And the next thing, calamity follows you. Who said it? Who showed them? You showed them. Come on, somebody. The mouth, your mouth will determine the kind of person you become. Are you the kind of person people can come for confidential issues, that they can come and disclose confidential things to you? Come on, Mara Official. I need to make sure that I'm not losing you as well. Make sure you're commenting. Talk to me, somebody. So, can I come and disclose my pain to you? Some people are even scared to tell people when they're sick because they know there are broadcasters incorporated who want to go around and be sharing and sharing and sharing their stories. You're already planning. You're already in the society. You are collecting monies for their burial. Meanwhile, they're still alive. And God turns it around like that and heals the person. So your mouth is a very serious matter. Hallelujah. The Bible says that the tongue is an iniquity and a fire. It's a fire. This thing, it can spread like wildfire. It's an iniquity and a fire. Hallelujah. Your mouth has a battery attached to it. It's called your tongue. And that battery can land you in hellhole if you're not careful. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So your words are carrying creative power, guys. Your words have got power to tear down. Your words are like a double barrel of missiles. They carry power. Your words can carry undying power, because some people are still going through what they're going through because of curses that were spoken about by their parents. Shakodia maasata kadiasata. No, you post the cars. You are a car dealer. Please post. You are advertising. It's your business. It's your business. You post the cars. Otherwise, how will we know about your car dealership? There is a structure, guys, on how you approach your social media. No shaking. No, the Lord will give you wisdom. You post the cars that you're selling. But you're going to have to get the word of God, and you're going to be praying. Because you may be, you're doing your work, right? And you're posting your cars for your car dealership. But back home in the village, they're thinking, oh, this one is so rich. They're thinking it's your cars. So you protect yourself. You cover them yourself in the blood of Jesus. Father, if these pictures end up getting where they shouldn't get to, my God, thank you, Lord, that I'm untouchable in Jesus' mighty name. Yes, Tando, don't bring people into your home. I know it's very beautiful. You want to show us off your best cutlery. You want to show off the new extension to your house that you want. There's not everybody that needs to come into your house. All those nice compliments, they don't really mean them, some of them. Some of them, yes, are genuine. That is why the discernment. That is why, guys, when you work the word of God says, you must have a discernment. Who are you bringing in? And what do you say? And to what extent? And stop telling people, my husband earns so much. Oh, my wife earns so much. I've got such a big allowance, blah, 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 blah. Meanwhile, the person is saying, no matter how much your friend can love you, they always want to be better than you. Take that with you as you go on to the rest of the day, as you are praying, and say, God, set a watch over my mouth. be the gatekeeper of my door. Is that not true, my Tao? No matter how much your friend loves you, they still want to be better than you. It's a fact. Even if they can say, no, they celebrate you, yes, but they wish in there, they still wish they could be better than you. Hallelujah. Your words have the power to heal. And that is why I say use your mouth for the right things. Use your mouth to heal. When people are arguing and they're trying to bring down somebody, bring words of healing. Bring the light. Be the light in that situation. Present other alternatives. Hallelujah. Be the one that brings words of healing. The people who are sick around you in your household, open up your mouth and exercise your authority as a believer and speak and rebuke the demons and rebuke the principalities, and you stand your ground and you speak the word in your house. Talk to me, somebody. Use your mouth to heal. Hallelujah. Words carry power. Your words can work wonders in your life. Your words can activate your angels to be working up and down. But you don't use your mouth for the right things. You want to comment about everything. You want to laugh about everything that you've got no business with. Talk to me, somebody. Words also carry poison. They can destroy the lives of people. You don't run with things that you don't have proof of. And even if you have proof of it, must you be the one who goes and announces it and you kill somebody's destiny, somebody's children. Somebody's children are depending on them. Those people are a breadwinner, and you have gone and ran your mouth unnecessarily because you were wanting to talk about them. It's none of your business. Somebody say, some things are none of my business. Somebody type in that comment section and say, some things are none of my business, and I need to stay out of it. Some things are none of my business. I can only pray for illumination. I can only pray that the person sees the right things. I can only hint that, you know, the people who are being cheated on, for example, they already know they're being cheated on. They're just being stubborn and they don't want to find out the truth. But all I can do is to pray and say, God, illuminate her eyes. Let her see what is going on. That, you know, this person, pray, God, let them detach from this person. Some things are none of my business, and I'm going to keep it that way in Jesus' name. Our words can deliver us from difficulty, and they can deliver us from trouble. Do you know that I've always said, one day I'll preach for you my message on smiling. Some people, your smile is the one that will open doors for you. Some people are just too morose. You are too angry. You come into places of authority that you are looking for favor in, but you cannot smile to people. Open up your words, your mouth. Open up your mouth and greet people. A simple greeting can open a door for you. Thank you for those who are following. Hallelujah. Please turn on the notification bell. I'm always on at 5 a.m. South African Standard Time. And we are also back at 10 p.m. And tonight, guys, it's Friday. It's Fasting Friday, so don't even think of going to eat. We are fasting today. We've got our 12 midnight prayer. Hallelujah. Your mouth can move mountains. Your tongue can move mountains. Your mouth can move mountains. Hallelujah. You can come out of difficulty or trouble because of your mouth. Some people, you have been saved because you just chose to greet somebody that you thought was insignificant. Did you greet the security guard when you came in? Did you greet the domestic worker when you came in? Your mouth can help you. Some of you are so rude. You know, you find some people who are rude to their domestic workers. You understand that this person handles your food in your house. You understand that this is the same person that stays with your child and looks after your child the whole day, and you want to talk to them as if they are nobody. You want to scatter them as if they're a filthy rag. I'm just saying, your mouth can either bring difficulties or goodness around you. If you know that you can't trust somebody and you want to restart, go get somebody else. But while that person is still working there, watch your mouth. Watch your mouth. Hallelujah. So your words can shape your life, your direction of your life. My God, I need to start praying now. My question to you this morning is that, what have you been saying? What kind of talk have you been listening to? What have been people saying around you? Listen to yourself from today. What are you saying? Is it necessary? Is it needed right now? Or am I just saying it? Yes, anoint my tongue every day, my God. Anoint my tongue. Your words will shape your life. They will shape your destiny. What have you been saying that has been destroying your destiny? Your words have a directing power. Your words can color your life negatively or positively. You decide. Your words can write failure in capital letters in your life. So you need to understand that whatever I've said with my mouth can either be saying failure or success. What is written on your forehead? Is it failure or is it success? Your words have destructive and tormenting power. Are you gonna be destructive? Are you gonna torment people? Are you the kind of mean manager that every time when you come around, they know that you're just going to be shouting? Believe you me, God is gonna brute you. It's just a matter of time. If you are a bad leader, God will dismantle you. You are a called man or a woman of God. Please, watch your mouth equally. There's one thing I can tell you is that especially if people who flow in the prophetic, they've got a very short fuse, right? But I'm saying this broadly to all the fivefold. Let's watch our mouth. Sometimes our mouths can either build or destroy. And that's why we always need to be guided by the Holy Spirit. And when you're doing when God has given you a word of rebuke or a correction, you can be rebuking somebody and it might seem painful, but the person will be able to take it because the anointing is available to make you understand that him who the Lord loves, he rebukes. But it's without doubt that we have seen other men and or people in leadership in the spiritual circles, and you just wonder and say, is that the mouth anointed by God? Do you understand what I'm saying? Let's check ourselves as well. This correction is for everybody. Mara Official, can you talk to me and tell me what's going on? Because I don't know whether we are having the same problem that we had, so that I can restart the live on that side as well. So your words have building power. Hallelujah. Your words have the power to spread anything that you say. God himself is a God of words. He is a God of speech. He's the one who spoke things into existence. He's the one who made the world with a word he spoke. So what you want to see in your life, what you want to create with your life, you are going to have to speak. Talk to me. Hallelujah. All things are existing and they're being held together by the word of God. Hallelujah. In the beginning, God spoke and said, let there be. Whatever you want to happen in your life, let there be. Come on, somebody. Jesus spoke to the angry waves and words. He spoke words, and those words spoke to the storm, and it had to listen. Let there be. What do you want to see happening in your life? Let there be. Thank you, Jesus. The same man who spoke to the dead and they came alive. Jesus spoke words and people came alive. Jesus spoke words and they came alive. You can wake up dead issues. I want you to use your mouth for good things. I want you to use your mouth and speak to the things that are dying in your life. I want you to use your mouth and speak to the issues that are not your dreams, that are not catching up. I want you to speak to the job that is that is toxic. I want you to speak to that environment that is toxic. I want you to speak to the marriage that is toxic. I want you to send words. I want your Lazarus to wake up in Jesus' mighty name. Somebody say, I will speak words. I will watch my mouth. What will come out my mouth will carry power. He spoke to the dead and they came alive. The same man spoke to the fig tree and the fig tree died. So you begin to understand that the same Jesus that raised Lazarus is the same Jesus that with his same mouth, he spoke to the fig tree and the fig tree dried up. So your words can kill and the words can build life. Hallelujah. It can either be life or it can either be death. Hallelujah. He was the same man who spoke to the fever, to Peter's in-law. And sickness had to bow. So do you understand that your mouth can make sickness to bow? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. When you open up your mouth and you keep on saying, my headache, my migraine, my arthritis, what are you saying? What are you saying? Your body is saying, okay, she says she's got migraine. I'm going to give her migraine. I'm going to intensify it. She says she's got a headache. I'm going to intensify it. Because you have said it's yours. Be careful. It's not your migraine. It's not your high blood pressure. I don't have... It's not my... Stop using my... You know, I've got this problem. I've got a migraine problem. You have it? That is exactly what the Holy Spirit is going to honor. Your body is saying, yes, you have it. That's how integrated your body is. Your body listens to your mouth. Your mouth is sending signals to your brain, to your heart, to your vessels, and is telling it. Because that is why you need to reach... Well, even if they gave you a diagnosis, child of God. Diagnosis, prognosis, whatever they call it. No, I don't have it in Jesus' name. Thank you, doctor. Thank you for highlighting that to me. What do you want to do? What is it? The intervention? Okay, I see it. Okay. But as soon as you get out of there and say, thank you, Jesus. I do not have cancer in my spirit. I don't have cancer in my body. In the mighty name of Jesus, I regret every sign and symptom of migraines in Jesus' mighty name. I reject any arthritis. I do not have arthritis in my body in Jesus' mighty name. These symptoms, I command you to go in Jesus' mighty name. I am not a parcel of any disease or diagnosis that has been spoken against my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, thank you, Lord, that you did not manufacture me with arthritis. You did not manufacture me with migraines. You did not manufacture me with funny diseases and names that I do not even know how to pronounce in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Now those words begin to enter your body. Life begins to enter your body. Everything starts to be aligned. Karabashondo, ilabasata kadiabasande. I am good. I am good. I'm feeling well in Jesus' mighty name. Father, thank you, Lord, that my feet are on solid ground. Father, I thank you, Lord, that I am revived. I am not fatigued in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I thank you. Even when you are driving, if you enter your car and you know you've not been sleeping, Lord, I thank you, I'm not fatigued. Lord, I thank you, I'm going to praise you and worship you throughout my whole driving, and I will reach my destination safely in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I am guarded, my angels are at work in Jesus' mighty name. You engage in praise and worship, hallelujah. Father, I thank you, Lord, that you have protected me, that, Lord, your angels are protecting me. I'm reaching my destination safely in Jesus' mighty name. You don't enter your car and start speaking fear, and you are saying, oh my God, they told me that when I go through this pass, they said, you know, a lot of accidents, this is a danger accident zone, and that's what you want to focus on. That is exactly what you will bring on. Come on, somebody. Come on, Fortunate Online. Keep tapping on the screen. Share your live broadcast in Jesus' mighty name. Share the live and make sure that you are following everybody who's on the broadcast so that you don't miss me when I come online. Hallelujah. God bless you. Hallelujah. Words are a dynamic force. Words are swords in your hands. Your words, they battle for success and they battle for your happiness. This is what you're going to use. You're going to use your mouth as you are battling for your success and happiness. And tonight at midnight, I need you to come ready, because we're going to dismantle certain things. We're going to dismantle certain spirits. Today, those spirits have been trying to torment me, and I said, never, never, never. I'm not backing down. I know that you are angry, devil, but I'm not backing down. I am going to be there, and I'm going to do it in Jesus' mighty name. When I started the broadcast here, there was a figure that was standing in front of me and trying to intimidate me, and I rebuked it. I said, not today, Satan, not today. I don't have that luxury for you. I don't have that time for you, because they didn't want me to speak this word. Hallelujah. Your words will produce wonders. Your words will produce those things that will bring you honor. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Your words can speak to objects. Hallelujah. And they will respond. Everything, your seed can respond. Hallelujah. Oh, shakadiaba. So when you call your name and you start prophesying, hallelujah, you prophesy goodness. You don't prophesy failure. You don't prophesy sickness. Talk to me, somebody. You lay hands on your head and you prophesy good things. You prophesy health on your head in Jesus' mighty name. You need to understand that even the witches and wizards use words, and incantations are words. So if the words of witches and wizards can carry power, your words can carry power as well. So you need to fight power with your words. Words must fight words. We create by the words that we say, hallelujah. Whether it's life or death, we create. Our words move mountains. Our words, our worlds are created by the words that we do. Our words, our weapons are the ones who are going to be determining or determined by our words that we release. Somebody say, watch your mouth. Hallelujah. I decree from today your mouth shall be like an aircraft. You are the pilot. You are the one who's going to determine the direction of that aircraft in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree and I declare that from today that your mouth will direct your life. Your mouth shall be the compass of your life. Your mouth shall be the control room of your life. Your mouth shall be the engine room of your life. Your mouth shall be the driver of your car in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I speak great words. I speak words of power. I speak words of goodness in Jesus' mighty name. Come on, come on. I need you to release those words in your life. I need you to cancel every single evil word and every negative word that has been happening in your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I want you to cancel it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Karabashoto niyamahasa takadia bahasa. Loko shete kiyama soto toto bosha kaniyama asata kadia. Hallelujah. Ah, we are not tail bearers. Hallelujah. Every evil word, we cancel it in Jesus' mighty name. We will not slander with our mouths. In Jesus' mighty name. Chido, I see you. Those on Facebook, let me give you attention. Hallelujah. Come on, talk to me, somebody. Somebody create with your words in the comment section. Create with your words in the comment section in Jesus' mighty name. You will not be a gossiper in Jesus' mighty name. I decree and I declare that you will not be one of those who are broadcasting the enemy's news. You will not be the one who's broadcasting your dreams and your goals prematurely in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree and I declare that your mouth shall release and be the bearer of good news in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I decree and I declare that somebody who will bring news that edifies to you are the words that you will hear in Jesus' mighty name. And you will equally be the person who is carrying good news, who is going to edify other people in Jesus' mighty name. You are going to exchange, my God, good news in Jesus' mighty name. You are not going to find yourself in discussions that are discussing useless words, but you are going to exchange knowledge. You are not going to find yourself in arguments where you are exchanging words of ignorance in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You need to understand, saying something, that when you are involved in an argument, you can decide the type of words that are going to build and how that argument is going to be resolved in Jesus' mighty name. You don't gain anything by arguing, because at an argument moment, people are heated up. People are not hearing anything. People say things out of ignorance. Hallelujah. You cannot gain anything when you are arguing with your spouse. Hallelujah. It's a waste of time. You both need to have cool heads in Jesus' mighty name. Karabashondakia. Do you know that there is a mystery that your ear works better when your mouth is shut? Hallelujah. I know there are people who are saying, I can listen to 3 conversations at the same time. But what if you could close your mouth and listen carefully and listen attentively, and then you know that you are receiving the right thing? Those of you on Mara Official, please do me a favor and find Fortunel online and jump on very quickly. Somebody please give them the link so that they don't get left out of the conversation. Hallelujah, hallelujah. What is wisdom saying? What is wisdom saying in Jesus' mighty name? Wisdom is saying that there is wisdom in keeping quiet. There is wisdom in silence. Hallelujah. Wisdom is keeping quiet when your talking will not improve the situation. If whatever you wanted to say will not improve the situation, it does not build anybody, shut your mouth. When wisdom is saying that it is time to keep quiet, anything that you say beyond that, you are no longer a master of your words. Hallelujah. Somebody say in the comment section, wisdom is saying keep quiet. Wisdom is silence. Yes, that's good. That's true. Wisdom is silence. Come on. Somebody say wisdom is silence in Jesus' mighty name. Wisdom is silence in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are not going to plant seeds of gossip. Those who gossip, people, if you gossip about people, people will also equally gossip about you. Anyone who is speaking, you are sowing a seed. I don't know what you're saying in the comment section, but I want to see what you're going to comment. I want to see the words that you're releasing. Talk to me, somebody. You are sowing seeds right now. The one who is listening, hallelujah, is going to reap something. The one who is sowing is going to reap something. If you are sowing seeds of goodness, you're going to reap a good harvest. Have you ever noticed that wise people talk less? Wise people talk less. It's always the people who don't have, by the way, that want to talk a lot. Not all of them, of course. But people, if you notice that even people who are wealthy, they speak less. They don't talk much. But people who just suddenly come into wealth, some wealth, nyana, not even big wealth, eh, they can run their mouth. Nari says, still waters run deep. Yes, you never know. Confuse the enemy. What are you thinking about? You are the master of unspoken words. Once your words get spoken, you are no longer the master. Anything you have not said, they cannot hold it against you, even in a court of law. If I have not said anything, you cannot accuse me of anything. You are a master of unspoken words. I said something powerful there. You are the master of unspoken words. If you have not said it, if you have said it, you are no longer the master, because they can manipulate it. They can say anything about it afterwards. As I close, when last did you say something that was untruthful about somebody? I want you to repent of that thing. When last did you say something untruthful? Ask the Lord for repentance for it. When last did you say something that was unkind about somebody? When last did you run to somebody and you were bringing news about what was said about them? Not what you even heard. You heard from somebody who heard from somebody, and you brought those words. And I'm saying there's room for correction this morning. When last did you say something that you truly regret? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for those who are repenting. May the Lord meet you at that repentance point and give you that repentance in Jesus' mighty name. When last did you verbally lash out at somebody? Some of us, we know that we have to repent. Probably some of us repent every third day. That's why I probably don't like driving too many times in the road, because when somebody, I can feel it. I can literally feel it. And then I have to suppress it and say, God, I'm born again. Hallelujah. Because I know some people can provoke you and you want to verbally lash out. Thank you, Jesus. I speak healing to your mother, Linda, in Jesus' mighty name. And you go and release the words. And as you are on this broadcast, if you are a person that is a student of the word and you are going to be prayerful, as you have stepped in right now, take the same words that I'm telling you right now and go and pronounce a healing right now. Let me teach you. Let me give you the practical thing. If you believe it, go and do it. Go lay hands on her right now. Father, we repent in Jesus' mighty name. When last ever we helped to spread gossip, Lord, we repent in Jesus' mighty name. Lord, we repent for the times we use the Lord's name in vain. We swore in Jesus' mighty name. We did everything that would not be pleasing to you. My God, we ask for forgiveness. We ask for repentance. Father, we thank you, Lord, for the moments that we have realized that we should have remained silent. Father God, we thank you for teaching us this morning that we will remain silent in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we will not exaggerate any stories that we have been told. My God, we are not going to be broadcasters to confirm things that we do not know anything about. Father, help us to mind our business. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're going to manage our mouth. Hallelujah. Father, I come and I decree and I declare, I deal with the spirit and the demonic spirit of lying. Father God, we uproot lying in Jesus' mighty name. May we may not be found perpetrating or broadcasting any lies in Jesus' mighty name. Any demon that has built a mansion in our tongues, the demon of lying, we rebuke you in the name of Jesus Christ. We uproot you, we cancel you, we destroy you in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I speak to every demon of negativity in Jesus' mighty name. Negativity shall not build a house in your mouth in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Negativity shall not bring flattery and boasting. My God, my God. God, your mouth shall not build mentions of flattery and boasting. You will not be boastful, but you will be humble. You will speak words of humility in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father God, I speak to the demon of hastiness in Jesus' mighty name. I speak to the demon of immorality, my God. When people have opened their mouth, my God, and spoken immoral things, oh God, that don't glorify your God, Father, we cancel it right now in the name of Jesus Christ, using your name in vain, participating in slander, my God. We ask for repentance right now. We ask for forgiveness, Father God. Any moment we have backslidden, any moment that we have participated in any form of backbiting, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we will not backbite anybody in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We'll not stab anybody in the back in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we understand the repercussions, and we have learned from your word this morning that gossip can destroy people. Father God, let us not have any hand on destroying any person in the name of Jesus Christ. We will not destroy any marriages in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Child of God, if the only time you hate gossip is when they're gossiping about you, then you're being a hypocrite. So you need to hate gossip period. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Manage the mouth. Know the dangers that we have pointed out this morning. Recognize when you are misusing your mouth. Understand that God gave you a tongue, and you are going to use that tongue to rejoice and give God the glory. Hallelujah. Confess your sins when you have done wrong and repent. Stop misusing your tongue. My friend had to come and ask for repentance for something that I did not even know she was the source. And I forgave her. And I say, don't ever do that. Don't ever do that. Till this day, they are still struggling. I forgave the person, but they are still not settled maritally. They have struggled. That is why I'm saying some things, it is God that will decide when they are releasing people. I have released. Come on, somebody. Refuse for your tongue to be used for the devil. If the devil is trying to make you repeat evil news, refuse and say, I'm not going to repeat that. 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 I'm not going to have my mouth saying that. I need you guys to minister deliverance to different people. Your tongue must minister deliverance to different people. If you cannot stop to talk rubbish and nonsense, I need you to keep quiet and teach your mouth and say, I will be silent. If you can hear that this thing that I'm about to speak is rubbish and it's nonsense, I'm going to keep quiet. Thank you to those who are joining. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I'm being told 80% of our goal. Thank you so much for those who helped. Oh my God, God bless you, Janica. Thank you so much for helping me reach the goal in Jesus' name. Thank you for the subscribers. Thank you guys for the giving. Thank you so much, really. Thank you for that partnership. If you are going to speak something, ask yourself the following questions. Is it true? Even if it's true, do I have to talk about it? Are we tracking together? Is it true? If it's true, do I have to talk about it? Is it my place to talk about it? Will it do anybody any good or any to tell it? Should I tell it? Will it help somebody? Maybe it will help somebody. If you know somebody's gonna die, then you talk it, you say it. Is it helping anybody? If it's not, why say something that is not gonna help anybody? You shut up. Is it inspiring? If it is inspiring, then you share it. Why I share my testimonies is because I know that they can inspire somebody, and somebody can know that even me myself, that if you know that even Pastor Fortune has gone through this and this is how they conquered it. Come on, somebody. Thank you, Jesus. It can help somebody. That's when I share my stories, even if it's something, whether it's sin. That's why I'm saying that I've opened up myself the vulnerability to say, I'm not saying I'm proud of any sin that I've committed, but I'm saying let somebody know that I also fell and I changed the way that I was doing things, and this is how it has helped me. When I speak to young women, especially single women, It's because I know the dangers and I know the pressures that can lead you astray and put you into more difficulty. And I'm sharing it out of the bottom of my heart to say, change for yourself and for your children. I'm talking for those who are also born, who have children born out of wedlock. Change. You are the template that your child is looking at. So the questions, I'm still on the questions. Does it edify? Is it something that will build people up? If it doesn't want to build people up, then you don't say it, just shut up. Is it something that's kind? If it's not, you shut up. Is it necessary? If the answer is no, you keep your mouth shut. Hallelujah. If someone will not say something in front of you or and in front of those concerned, do not listen to them, because that person does not have the guts. If how do you know it's gossip? They can't say it in front of you. They can't say it in front of the other person that they're gossiping about. If somebody brings gossip and say, let's go to the person, let me come in, let me organize a meeting so that we can address this issue. Let me organize a meeting so that we can organize this issue and you can address this issue and that person can answer for themselves. You need to receive a new heart this morning from Jesus. And you say, God, Father, cleanse me, renew the right spirit within me. Hallelujah. So those of you who need to ask God for help, you know your mouth has landed you into trouble. Father, we ask for help this morning. Help us to know how to hold our tongues in Jesus' mighty name. Help us to learn and to listen before we speak. To learn and to listen before we speak. Those dangerous, wicked words that you have been saying to your husband, to your wife, the terrible names that you have been calling your children, the, you know, people with, you know, you are calling them stupid, you are calling them useless and everything, they need to stop. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, as we have begun to repent before you, Lord, any area in which we need to repair, to repent, any area of our mouths that needs repairing, Father, we come to you this morning and we say, forgive us, Lord. We don't want to repeat any errors that we have made in the past. We don't want to sabotage ourselves through our mouths or whatever we have said in the past. We don't want to be a failure. And Father God, we ask that you wipe the slate clean from whatever evil words that we have spoken in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we speak to our mouths right now. We ask, Lord, let the fire of God anoint our mouths in Jesus' mighty name. Receive that fire of God on your mouth in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, as I pray and I stand in agreement, I declare and I decree to everybody who is at the sound of my voice right now, any power that has been assigned to turn our glory into shame because of our mouths, Father, I decree and I declare that that power is a liar in the name of Jesus Christ. It shall not happen in Jesus' mighty name. Any power that has to move aside for us to go forward, Father God, we command it to move aside in Jesus' mighty name. Any giants that anybody is facing, my God, they came with different needs. They came with different issues, my God. Some came because they were ill, Father God. But I know, my God, that even in this word of rebuke and in this word of correction, oh God, that you're going to help them correct the things that have been delaying their miracles, the thing that have been delaying their healings in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we thank you. Any problem that came into our lives because of our tongue, because of our mouth, Father, we command that thing to die in the name of Jesus Christ. Any problem that has been repeating itself in our lives because of our mouth, Father God, uproot it from us in Jesus' mighty name. Deal with it, my God. Any self-imposed curses, Father, we command right now that they are breaking in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, as we make the vow and we say we shall never be part of any gossiping, we shall no longer be permitting ourselves to be around gossip in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we refuse to mortgage our blessings with evil words, with a reckless tongue, with a careless tongue in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible says a fool's mouth is his destruction, and his lips are the snare of his soul. That's the scripture we started with in Proverbs 18:7. And I believe I'm not talking to fools to this morning. I'm talking to people who are not going to let their mouth lead them to destruction. I'm talking to people who are not going to live their lips to take them to be a snare to their souls. Hallelujah. Consider the words that you're speaking. Hallelujah. My mouth will determine the direction of my life today. My mouth will determine the direction of everything that I'm dreaming about and all my goals. Hallelujah. My life today will be a function of every declaration that I'm making right now. So right now, begin to make those declarations. What do you want to see? Hallelujah. Your life is going to be determined right now by your mouth. Every declaration that you are making right now in Jesus' mighty name. If you want to join the WhatsApp group, there's a video on my thingy that's got a barcode, but you can always inbox and I'll respond with a link. Make sure you follow me on social media channels, Fortunelle Online. And I think if you send me a message on Instagram, I know some of you might not be using your Instagram for anything else. Give me a follow there. I'll follow you back on Instagram. Send a message on Instagram. Send a message on Facebook. Because I think the privacy laws on TikTok are a bit more stricter. So normally when you exchange phone numbers, you can't even exchange a phone number with somebody that you're not following back. And you can't, like, if you share emails and stuff like that, that's sensitive. That's why I'm always directing you guys to say, if you send it on IG, then I can always paste the link and then you can just click on the link and you'll be in the WhatsApp group. Hallelujah. Your mouth shall not lack control from today in Jesus' mighty name. You will no longer pronounce words that are going to be destructive in Jesus' mighty name. The Bible says, I say to you, every idle word that men speak, they shall give account thereof in the day of judgment. Don't let your words make you account for things that are useless. Things that are destructive. The words in your mouth are potent. I'm recapping just for everybody who just came in late. Somebody say, watch your mouth. Your words have healing powers. Your words can work wonders in your life. As I'm saying this, you can actually declare it back because I'm actually giving you what the scripture is. So when I tell you, your words have healing powers, you say, I declare healing in my life. You can be declaring that person who is ill in your life. That's Fortunelle Online, that's pinned. You follow that account on Facebook and on Instagram, and you follow my YouTube channel and you subscribe. And we can communicate on any of those platforms as well. I declare healing in my life. I declare healing in my child's life. Whoever needs healing, this is how you do it. I'm teaching you how to frame your declarations. Your words will work wonders in your life. You declare again, Father, I declare and I decree that I'm a wonder. Signs and wonders follow me. Father God, I am for signs and wonders. Signs and wonders are following me in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you, Lord, that my words can redefine my destiny. I declare and I decree that my destiny is good. My destiny is shining. My destiny is rising. My God, my destiny shall come into fulfillment. My destiny is being redefined. My destiny will no longer be spoiled and damaged by the enemy in Jesus' mighty name. My words can color my life in a positive way. Father, what in whatsoever way my life has been darkened, in whatsoever way that the lives of my family members have been in a dark place, my God, we ask that you bring color, and that color will bring rejoicing in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Is somebody learning how to pray this morning? Is somebody learning how to take that declaration? Come on, talk to me, somebody. I need to teach you how to take scriptures and you turn it around and you understand that you get fired up. You see the importance of the word. How you hear me pray and how you hear me declare. I'm just declaring out of the abundance of the heart. The mouth speaks. The abundance of the heart that I've deposited inside there. I've deposited the word of God and I shoot it out like that. And it has to come to pass because I'm calling God into accountability. And I say, you said you will not dishonor your word. You are going to carry your word. My words carry success. My words will bring success and not failure in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I decree and I declare that this morning my mouth shall not speak words of failure in the name of Jesus Christ. I will not engage myself in any word that is going to bring destruction, but the words that I will speak and utter will always be attracting success in my life in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I declare and I decree that my words possess life in Jesus' mighty name. I possess the power of life and death, and therefore I make a conscious choice. I am not negligent about the choices that I make. My mouth shall speak life in the name of Jesus Christ. I possess the power of life. I release life in my business. I release life in my career. I release life in my children's life in Jesus' mighty name. Come on, somebody. My God, I release the word of God in my life. The mysteries of the word of God, the revelations of the word of God, they are taking effect in my life and directing my path. My God, I am growing spiritually in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Everything around me has to respond to the word that I've deposited inside of me. Everything around me has to respond to the word that I've planted. My God, every seed, every prophetic word that I've received, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I speak life to every prophetic word, every prophetic declaration that I've made in Jesus' mighty name. My God, I cancel every negative prophecy that has been spoken over my life and over my family in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, I will not prophesy negative words. I will stop claiming diseases that you did not give me, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. I will speak life to my body. I will speak that I'm walking in divine health in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I will speak and declare that I am I've got authority as a believer. I've got authority to trample upon serpents. I've got authority that no poisonous substance will ever harm me or kill me in the name of Jesus Christ. And Father God, as I go out and I step out of this broadcast, even into my day or in my evening, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I decree and I declare, my God, I'm empowered and I'm in charge. I'm sitting on the head of the devil and I'm in charge, and he has no right to come into my house and run around helter skelter the way he wants in the name of Jesus Christ. Father God, I stop the battle at the gate. Any demonic activity that wants to enter my house, any demonic activity that wants to enter my brain, I stop you at the gate. My God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I am fortified. My hedge of protection is intact in the name of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus speaks for me. The blood of Jesus wipes away every single evil word that I've spoken in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I ask for forgiveness for those that I will be able to repent to. I will repent to also and ask for forgiveness from them. Everybody that has already passed on, or maybe they are no longer around, my God, I ask for forgiveness, my God, and I ask for forgiveness, and I forgive myself as well in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, I cancel every curse that has been spoken by my uncle, by my mother, by my father in the name of Jesus Christ. My God, and whatever motive that they came right now in Jesus' mighty name, I cancel it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, I release favor, I release success, I release greatness in Jesus' mighty name. Every slanderer around me be canceled in Jesus' mighty name. Every slanderer, move out of my path. Every gossiper, move out of my far path in Jesus' mighty name. Every satanic broadcaster, catch fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Every good news broadcaster, come through for me in the name of Jesus Christ. Every destiny broadcaster, come through in Jesus' mighty name. My God, in Jesus' mighty name, help me, Lord. Watch over my mouth, oh God, that I will not be silent when there is nothing to say. My God, I will not be silent when I can speak goodness, but I will speak goodness in that time. But anytime, my God, I don't have anything to say, help watch over my mouth and be the doorkeeper to my mouth, that I will not speak that which I should not speak. My God, help me to exercise silence in Jesus' mighty name. I will not talk for the sake of talking in Jesus' mighty name. Come on, somebody. Is somebody sounding a resounding amen in that comment section right now? In Jesus' mighty name. Wise men will listen to me when I talk, because they know that I don't talk idle words. I don't talk. Father, my mouth is in control in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I will not be running down others with my mouth. I will not just be verbally speaking verbal garbage out of my mouth. I will not be talking badly about people. I will not be talking my mind, but I will talk the mind of Christ always in Jesus' mighty name. I will not be verbally lashing out at other people, my God. I will not say things that I will later regret in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, as I speak and right now, as I decree and I declare, Father, let there be a softening of the hearts in those that have had problems in their marriages in Jesus' mighty name, where arguments were not necessary, my God. I ask for the softening of hearts, my God. I ask for the forgiveness, Lord, that words that were spoken, my God, that were destroying that family, my God. I ask for the blood to blot them out in Jesus' mighty name. I ask for a management of the mouth, that people will learn how to speak to their spouses and respect each other, my God, in Jesus' mighty name. That families will be rebuilt because of this in Jesus' mighty name. Father, I will not confirm any gossip. I will not confirm any exaggeration. Father God, I will not backbite in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord, that my mouth has been brought into deliverance in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you to those who are gifting as well. Hallelujah. I receive that healing. Somebody has got a pain in your heart right now. Right now. You just had a stabbing pain right now. It's gone. In Jesus' mighty name. It's gone now. I'm waiting for that confirmation. It's gone. Let the Holy Spirit guard your mouth in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You never speak unless He gives you permission. Unless the Holy Spirit gives you permission, you don't speak. Thank you for that confirmation. Thank you, Jesus. Every bondage, every destruction in my tongue, I command you to die in Jesus' name. I will not speak words that lead me into bondage. I will not speak words that lead me to destruction in Jesus' name. Every spirit of poison in my mouth, catch fire. In the name of Jesus. Blood of Jesus, purge my mouth. Come on, let's pray together. The blood of Jesus is pledging, is purging your mouth right now in Jesus' mighty name. The fire of God is purging your mouth in Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The resurrection power of Jesus is resurrecting every good thing that your mouth has killed in Jesus' mighty name. I declare that today through your mouth, you will be able to control your blessings. You will be able to release your blessings. Siabonga. I close every evil gate that is open in your life through the mouth, through the things that have been said over your life in the name of Jesus Christ. There are things that have been spoken into your life, Siabonga, and you don't know why things have not been working. And you are a good person and you keep on trying to do good, but there's like, you don't understand. You're just thinking and you're minding your business. But the Holy Spirit is showing me that there were words that were spoken. Thank you, Jesus. I close that door in the name of Jesus Christ. Akanamasha takadia hasata. I'm looking for you, Siabonga. If you don't come through, I am going to. Okay, there we go. There we go, my angel. Karabasho tokolia masata kadia bahasata. Jeketia makolia baso tokolia masa. You agree. Kalabasha ndedia masa. Thank you for confirmation. Kadia baso tokolia. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. This is not fiction. What do you call it?
It's not a novel. Karabashoto kodia maasata karia baasata. Rikalamashoto kodia mashanda. I close every evil gate into your life that has been spoken through the mouth. Every evil gate that has been opened through the mouth. In the mighty name of Jesus. Kurabasha laliamasa takadiamasa. Jekeliamasande diamasho kodiamaso tokodiamasa. Jenkev. The Lord will give you the Lisa. It's being reversed in Jesus' mighty name. You still got time to reverse it. Jenkev. You're gonna start, your humility will start speaking for you. And I stand in the gap with you. I speak to your marriage right now. You did not know. The Lord is correcting it for you right now. You did not know, but the Lord is going to give you the wisdom and he's going to give you the strength. He's going to give you the strength to watch your mouth. I baptize you right now. I baptize that mouth, that tongue. You will speak good. There will be a shock in your house. Shakuna masa takadia masa takadia. If the enemy has stolen from you, you need to recover it by force in the name of Jesus Christ. You must make up your mind. I'm going to stop them before they stop me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for speaking. Makwana mashata kalia baso tokoria bahasha takadia sataka. Ikala maso tototoboshi akadia masata kadia baha. In the name of Jesus, karabashata kadia basanda. I speak to that addiction. I command it to leave in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. I speak to that addiction and I command it to leave in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oath of God, that's for you. In the name of Jesus. Oh, may the Lord bless you and increase you. Oh, my Clara, may the Lord bless you and increase you. From today, your words will carry honor like never before. You will see people that respect you. People are going to consult you for advice. Can somebody keep on declaring, watch my mouth. Keep on declaring what you want the Lord to do for you. Keep on canceling those things that you know that you that went wrong, that were trying to destroy. Father, I protect every placenta in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every placenta, every pregnancy right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It is protected in the name of Jesus Christ. You will carry to full term and you will have a safe delivery in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Jesus. Zviwe, you're going to experience peace like never before in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every negative word spoken over your life and over your children's life, it is canceled in Jesus' mighty name. Every word that you also spoke against yourself in Jesus' mighty name.
Shakona masa takalia basa takalia. Henrik, are you in the creative industry? Makora basha takalia masa takalia. Shonda kia masoto kodia masa takalia ba. Father, I thank you, Lord, for mental health for Brenda in Jesus' mighty name. She will not lose it in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Makora basoto kodia masa. Nari, there has been some arguments from one of your relatives concerning your preparation for marriage. There's a lot of chit-chat around it. Thank you, Jesus. I cancel it in the name of Jesus Christ. Whatever the plan, Shakuna masata kalia basata. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Anna, for standing in the gap with me. Thank you, my sweetheart. Thank you. I really appreciate it. They're coming in fast. Thank you so much. Who did I? Nari, there's arguments from your male side of the family. Father, whatever the plan is that is trying to frustrate the plans of that wedding, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I speak to it right now in Jesus' mighty name. I decree and I declare the marriage shall go smoothly in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, I pray for Sister Janica in Jesus' mighty name. I thank you, Lord, that business, that it will not only be restored, but it will overflow in Jesus' mighty name. Karabasondo dodoboshi ama kalamasanda. Bongi. None of your siblings are working, and they are of working age. Bongi masangu. Masangu. There is an embargo that has been placed in your family. Guys, I need you to confirm first so that I move on. Otherwise, I move on to somebody else and I need to close because we've passed our due time for closing. So I really want to pray, and for those I can, so that I can get ready for midnight prayer. It will explode, Dr. Catherine, in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we speak. Open doors, open. Let it explode. My God, in Jesus' mighty name, we speak expansion. Expansion. Expansion in Jesus' mighty name. Emmanuel, soak yourself in the word and start praying more. MMM, please be there. We speak expansion. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you so much. Thank you, Jesus. Janike, Dr. Catherine, I speak expansion in your business in Jesus' mighty name. Rukana masato konia masata kadia ba. May God give you better financial management, Nomdombendle, in Jesus' mighty name. There is something that is definitely eating away at your monies. It's eating away at your monies. You are not, there's definitely a charm that is eating away your money. Thank you, Jesus. Miche, have they finished paying for your lobola? Miche, M-I-C-H, have they finished paying for your lobola? I pray for Tini's sister in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit, we ask, oh God, that healing may come to her body right now in Jesus' mighty name. We ask for the faith of the family to be strengthened in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, Jesus. Okay, I was waiting for Spongile to come back. I wanted to tell you why there's an embargo at your house, but I don't know, maybe you already commented and these things are coming in fast. There's just too many things going on. I think I'm going to leave everything to midnight prayers and we just see how God takes us there, because we have the whole night. People need to go to work. Please make sure you give me a follow and you turn on the notification bell. On my profile, you're going to find my YouTube link and my Instagram link. You click on that button that says Instagram. You click follow on Instagram. You click on that button that says Instagram. It will give you a drop down of YouTube as well. And you are on it in Jesus' mighty name. You will subscribe to YouTube. Then you can send me a message on IG. Send you the link for the WhatsApp group. Otherwise, you go to my pinned, not even my pinned, my videos. There is a WhatsApp group link that you just scan and you will be in the WhatsApp group for the announcements and every time we come on live. Thank you, Jesus. I want to start saying my thank yous to those, Misha, I asked you whether or not you have completed your wedding. Okay, while you are, please, Misha, I'm not going to be able to see because I'm watching the two screens here on Facebook and on YouTube. Guys on YouTube and Facebook, thank you so much for joining. If you are able, come and be on TikTok if you still got time, if you're not starting work already. But I want to say thank you. God bless you. And please like the video. And follow the channel that you are on. And otherwise, we'll see each other tonight. Tonight is Friday, right? Can somebody confirm tonight is Friday? Jayshree, are you explaining your phone call? You are expecting a phone call. May it be granted in Jesus' name. May it come through. We stand in agreement that call that you have been waiting for is going to come through. Today is Friday, so tonight, midnight, we are having a session, guys, which means there is no 10 o'clock. So our miracle night that we normally have with Apostle Mara is going to fall into our 12 midnight. We're going to start at 12 midnight. We normally scheduled for 3 hours, but let's see how the Spirit of God goes, okay? So daily, I'm live 5 a.m. And Fridays, 12 midnight. So while Apostle Mara has given me his 10 o'clock slot, we've moved it to 12 a.m. So I'll see you at 12 a.m., okay? Facebook and YouTube. God bless you. Thank you so much, my darlings. Thank you so much. Those of you who want to watch the repeat, you